Perfect harmonious balance. That's the dream of a developer when piecing together the landscape for any competitive multiplayer arena. Such lofty aspirations will never be realized, of course, thanks to the impossibility of predicting player behavior. But that doesn't mean the alternative has to be a grossly imbalanced hellscape where one emergent weapon combo or poorly tuned murder tool reigns supreme over all others. Because sanity is a valuable human trait, so why is it that developers, when it comes to these weapons, seem keen to craft tools seemingly designed to smash it all to f**k? And yeah, many, but not all, of these cheesetastic weapons have since had their effectiveness curbed for the sake of controller and console safety, but documentation of their raw, unaltered forms lives on in the scarred minds of their many victims. I'm Josh from WhatCulture.com, and these are 10 overpowered video game weapons that made you rage quit. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to stay notified. Ding, ding, done. Number 10. The M16A4, Call of Duty 4, Modern Warfare. Believe it or not, Call of Duty's first modern day outing had a suite of different ordnance types, all vying for a spot in your soldier's space limited loadout, but Call of Duty 4's problem was never a lack of variety. Rather, unless you fancied gimping yourself in a battle, the only logical choice for filling your avatar's hands would be the M16A4, with, of course, stopping power selected as a perk. The M16 wasn't broken, but it stuck out like a sore thumb compared to the well-balanced other weapons, and it did narrow the gap between the top tier and newcomers thanks to obnoxious aim assist and an inbuilt ability to kill in a single burst regardless of which body part took the brunt of its force. Infinity Ward opted to not rein in its ferocity through subsequent patches, a mistake if we ever saw one, as if you threw steady aim onto this bad boy you could essentially get to the top of the leaderboard one-handed. Number 9. Uriel's Gift, Destiny 2. Thanks to Bungie's over-reliance on reskins, Uriel's Gift has no defining physical characteristics. It's just another legendary auto-rifle existing amongst a sea of similar-looking firearms. But as any Guardian worth their salt knows, it's the perks that accompany a weapon that defines its popularity, not its looks. In fact, the right combination can make even a rusted antique a deadly Guardian-killing machine in the Crucible. And that's exactly what Uriel's Gift is. A god-roll tool of death that single-handedly beats every other weapon in its class thanks to an infallible stat sheet. Zero recoil, bonus accuracy on trigger pull, and, thanks to the obnoxious high-caliber rounds perk, bullets that cause knockback make it the first choice for any engagement besides situations when combatants are close enough to shag each other's faces off. Number 8. The Redeemer, Unreal Tournament. An aptly named weapon of mass destruction if we ever saw one, the Redeemer doesn't exist as a reward for participants that are doing well, no, but a random pickup of the map that just so happens to be so brain dead easy to get kills with that the only prerequisite for going from zero to hero with it in hand is a working pair of thumbs. All you have to do is point, shoot, and guide your remote controlled explosive across enemy lines for a free, risk-free kill. Well, a singular kill only if you're unlucky. Given its fat man-sized blast radius, just one rocket from the Redeemer can wipe out an entire team, because, you know, having a match decided by a single game-swinging action involving little skill is always fun, right? Number 7. Proximity Mines, GoldenEye 007. What, you expected guns in a shooter? Don't be daft, in GoldenEye 007 all you need are mines. Mines, mines, and more f***ing mines. See, bullets here are only efficient if the wielder has a keen eye and the uncanny ability to properly use the Nintendo 64's worst controller of all time, making other items far more viable. Boring concepts like skill or learning aren't necessary when you can grab a stack of proximity mines and become the world's most obnoxious camper, immune to conventional weaponry and the calls of your three friends walking out after the match. You can, of course, opt to continue playing, but it'll be a game of Minesweeper, not GoldenEye, from here on out. Number 6. Ringed Knight Paired Greatswords, Dark Souls 3. From Software, keen to go out with a bang for Dark Souls 3's final slice of DLC, threw considerations of balance to the wind with the Ringed City's Paired Greatswords, which, unless they come to clash with a bona fide PvP master, will cleave Ashen Ones down to their very soul, and there's not a damn thing you'll be able to do about it. The series' competitive scene has always been a numbers game at heart, but none of that mattered if your opponent wielded these hope-devouring bastard swords. Slow they may be, but getting getting caught in a single sweep would lock your undead down for a follow-up combo, meaning one mistake and you'd be toast. From Software reined the weapon's power in with a follow-up patch, but that would never quiet the haunting screams elicited by its unnerfed form. Number 5. Photon Projector, Overwatch. Given the fluid, ever-changing nature of Overwatch's meta, thanks to Blizzard's continued pursuit of a perfect balance, its heroes rise and fall on the power scale on a regular basis. Symmetra, often considered to be one of, if not the, weakest combatants at launch, received a much-needed overhaul at the tail end of 2016, which repositioned her from trash pick to god tier. Much of that came as a result of her suite of new abilities, but thanks to Symmetra's reworked Photon Projector, she became a one-size-fits-all pick, able to fulfill every role by way of absurd healing, damage multipliers, and a huge range. Given the choice, you didn't fight Symmetra mano-a-mano, you legged it back to your team, only for her to follow and single-handedly wipe out your entire crew. Number 4. The M203 Grenade Launcher, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. Bigger, bolder, and more bombastic, that was Infinity Ward's mantra for Modern Warfare 2, and it paid off. Mostly. The M203 Noob Tube Grenade Launcher existed in Modern Warfare 2's predecessor, but not like this. Good lord, not like this. Yes, Infinity Ward had provided a huge selection of traditional, bullet-spewing weaponry for this sequel, but weapon loadout came down to one simple choice. Can this gun use the underbarrel M203? If yes, use it, and a second one if possible, and enjoy crushing the other team without ever having to concern yourself with the necessity of aiming. To make matters worse, with the right loadout, grunts could infinitely spam explosive ordnance until the other team either responded in kind or retired their controllers by way of flinging them out a window. And yeah, there are other weapons in Modern Warfare 2 that were f***ing infuriating, don't get me wrong, but nothing made you rage quit quicker than launching into a match only to be instantly killed at your spawn by a rogue noob tube. Number 3. The Plasma Pistol, Halo 2. As the M6 Magnum had done before it, Halo 2's plasma pistol continued the trend of absurdly powerful sidearms in Bungie's OG sci-fi universe. The snot-colored plasma emitted from the Covenant's alternate fire when fully charged would insult what little semblance of skill that other weapon required by immediately chasing down any enemy vaguely within the weapon's sights until it hit its target, instantly stripping them of their shield and, seconds later, their life. And if you dual wielded this with an SMG, then give me your names in the comments and I'll call the police right now. Fortunately for our sanity, Bungie destroyed the weapon's usefulness in Halo 3 and Reach by neutering its homing capabilities, range, and ability to remain charged indefinitely. Good. Stay dead. Number 2. The AWP Counter-Strike. Although the Counter-Strike series has prided itself on having a strong selection of balanced weapons over the years, the AWP, or any variation of the iconic sniper rifle, has continued to haunt the memories of longtime players. Being a brutal harbinger of death, one shot from this rifle, as long as it was above the legs anyway, is all it would take to bring your hopes of a glorious ace crashing to the ground. Switch glitching didn't help make the weapon feel any less cheap either, and if it doesn't kill you, you might as well wish it had, as the weapon also deals some of the highest armor penetration damage in the series with little distance drop-off, leaving you on half health and even being able to travel through goddamn steel doors. Look, I know Counter-Strike is for the hardest of the hardcore, but the AWP can leave even the most calm and collected players as nothing more than a whimpering mess of tears. Number 1. The Nasher Shotgun, Gears of War. At one time or another, no matter the iteration, Gears of War's eviscerating Nasher shotgun has been at the forefront of controversy. But no iteration of the COG soldier's best friend has been as inherently overpowered as the original. Whoever happened to be the host would practically be in god mode anyway, able to react to and register damage faster than latency-stricken participants. And then you'd have the laughably weak Lancer that took an age to stop the impending onslaught of a trigger-happy Nasher user who'd happily brush off your bullets. Roll, crouch, run, try whichever maneuver you wish, once a Nasher wielder made it into the optimal range of your soon-to-be lifeless body, the tight spread of its buckshot would blow you into a million pieces. Oh, and let's not forget the franchise's wonderful active reload mechanic, which would let players down you in one shot if its muzzle was so much as visible to the naked eye. What a wonderful, horrible bastard that was.
Hey guys, thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe below. And if you're looking for more content like this, then try a few things that are floating about around my ears. Might be fun. I can't promise it though, but it might be. Thank you.